gentlemen, good afternoon. I'm not going to get into all the details of what comes up at 4:30 and 30 minutes from now, but we have a special Rosh Hashanah program for you, so I want you to stay tuned for that. But first, here's 30 minutes in Hebrew.
שלום רב וברוכים הבאים לתוכניתנו, כאן דני ישראלי, שנה טובה לכולם. בתוכניתנו היום, אומנית ישראלית בשם עטרה בייקר, גבי ברלין, מספר שירי ארץ ישראל יפים, קטע היתולי בקשר לחגים. את פינתי הקדשתי לסקירה קצרה על השנה שחלפה, ומספר בקשות צנועות בקשר לשנה הבאה עלינו לטובה.
כמו... תראה כמה טוב יהיה בשנה.
עבודתה מאוד מעניינת, הווה ונראה.
For Israeli-born artist Atara Baker, South Africa's native cultures are a wellspring of inspiration for awakening and rediscovering the primeval tribal heritage linking all peoples. The vitality of Atara's work lies in its embrace of nature and the expression of cultural values and beliefs that have survived all times. Her oil and mixed media works are earth-toned and are evocative of African tribal masks or ancient paintings upon soot-covered cave walls. Atara's mask cut through the clutter of modern society, creating a link between what it is to be human today and the core experience of primitive cultural life. Her paintings reflect eons of human existence in nature and connect ancient cultures to the modern era through universal modes of artistic representation. By including artifacts from our own modern industrial society, Atara's works continue in the tradition of primitive peoples, whose very tools were also works of art. In some of Atara's later works, Hebrew messages have been inscribed as tributes to the vision of her mentor in South Africa, the late artist Bill Ainslie. After growing up in Israel, Atara Baker spent a decade in South Africa, where the timeless qualities of the Bushman culture profoundly influenced her artwork. Her studies have also taken her throughout Europe and America, finally locating her studio in Southern California.
I want to bring kind of a back influence of the Bushman people and yet go back to our time using all kind of material that I find in every day. The color that I'm using is mostly earth tone. I don't use any other colors like very bright blue because I try to relate it more and less to the African mask. I'm a white person and I don't live in Africa. I don't live in a village. I live in a city life. And I try to bring all the experience that I again, South Africa.
Moriah Hotels, Israel's best location.